introduced earlier. You know him, I know him. The first time I saw him was yesterday. Well, I saw him on the TV, and I heard him on the radio. I saw him on the Twitter, I saw him on Facebook, saw him on his website. It has a lot of traffic. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Africa's top cyberpreneur. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. No other person than, come on, keep bringing it, a teacher, a mentor, a motivator to share personal experience and knowledge, to speak, to time, to the time, touch, improve, motivate, and establish lives. Not a person, come on, ring it, four, Japheth, Omojuwa. Come on, you can do better than little scream. Come on, scream it now.
Can I call you Mr. J, because you sounded really nice on stage?
Yeah, I mean,
all right, so Mr. J, real quick, I want to find out from you, since you are out at the Speak Initiative, I want to know how it was for you, your experience coming on Speak Initiative. What do you think the youth should learn from all this kind of activities?
First of all, I think they should stop thinking of themselves as youths, because there's no currency in being a youth. They should think of themselves as bona fide adults who have to contribute to society. And then I think that every opportunity to learn is an opportunity that one should grab. It doesn't matter how far you've gone in life. Any chance to learn should be something that, as a young person or as an old person or whoever, if you want to continue to make progress, if you want to continue to improve on your product, you have to grab. And I think this is an essential opportunity for students here.
Yes, we are looking at 2015, and like you said, they are bona fide adults. So what do you think, the bona fide adults, what do you think their input and their attributes should be concerning 2015? Things that they should put into place, things that they should put into action that will make them more relevant even in 2015?
I'm not going to talk about 2015, I'm going to talk about now, because 2015 will come and go. The most important thing is to focus on now. So whatever they can put in place, whatever they need to put in place, they need to put in place now. Whatever they think they can do with their lives, they need to start doing now. Whatever ideas they want to get started with, they have to get started with now. We should be careful with looking at numbers, 2015, 2019, because they have a way of distracting you from what is important. So if you think something has to be done and you think that thing is important, get it started immediately. And then 2015 will come, and then you'll be in a good place. And then 2019 and the other ones will come. That's what.
Thank you very much, Mr. Daffod. It was lovely having you in Ilorin. All right, thank you very much.
Gentlemen, please welcome me, a young man. He's very chubby. But every day he just keeps adding it. And then I ask him, okay, Afra, you give me small. Ladies and gentlemen, he's loaded. And when he contagious you, you marvel. Please welcome the whitest man here today. Ladies and gentlemen, he smiles better. He smiles good. He's tush. He loves to motivate the youth. He loves to do better. And above all, I've been sitting at the hedge of Contagious 128 Media. Ladies and gentlemen, Shola Adewumi is a Nokia brand ambassador. Please put your hands together for my brother, Shola Adewumi.
You were at the Speak Initiative. What do you think about it? What do you think about the initiative itself?
It's a good one. It's the kind of thing that if you have more of it, then students will get to grow. So there's a sharp difference between education and hands-on, between education and motivation. If I had my way, I'd slash what we do in class and what we do out of class. So, and these are the kind of things that will help people grow more in those other things that are needed, aside just books and works. I mean, the more you do this, the better for all of us.
People get more hands-on experience and learn from those that are doing what they exactly.
Definitely. So there are two ways of learning, of experiencing something. Either you experience it through someone who has experienced it, or you yourself want to go into it. If you've ever had a friend who impregnated a girl at 13, I can assure you, you will not do the same. Yeah, so that's the kind of thing. And same thing that happens in this case. I mean, so the more you interface with people that are already doing what you want to do, the better for you.
So you said a couple of things when you were inside. You were talking about internship being very key. I don't know, do you have any ideas on which to help our youths, like how to boost them in terms of going into internship, looking for internship? Are there things that they should look out for? Yeah. Are there things that they should go? Because, you know, a lot of people just say internships and they just go to just anywhere, you know? Mm. So are there any point out, things that you can point out for them? Okay, when you're looking for internship, this is where to go to. Mm. Things like that. You know?
Okay, so I don't know of any organization that helps you with internship. I mean, okay, I think I know ISEC does, JCI does, but I don't know of any organization that helps you with it. But I think it's more of an individual thing. Because remember again that the goal is yours. You're the one that knows that you want to be the best accounting lawyer, if there's anything like that. So you're the same person that should identify where are the best accounting firms, where are the best law firms. You know, then how do I now get to meet someone in there who would allow me to do an internship there? And as I say, we're all 4 people away from wherever we want to meet. So if you identify a certain place that you know you want to work, you know that what they do there is what you'd like to do. You are 4 calls away from anybody in there. Once you find them, go there. I always advise, don't ask them for money. Because once you tell someone that you pay you, if the guy begins to think about his bottom line and the fact that you don't even know anything, so you can't add anything, so you can't add value to him. But when you say, listen, I'm willing to work for free for 3 months to do an internship in here, the guy doesn't see any problem. He's thinking maybe an extra seat, an extra chair. That's all he's going to take him. But within those 3 months, if you end up delivering value, you end up showing people that you're a potential. That's all.
All right. Finally, just real quick, before you go, you said one of the key points that I also picked up from your speech was in terms of attitude. You know, and like they say, attitude says a lot. But are there key points that people should hold, like things that they should realize that, okay, this is something that I need to change in my attitude. These are the things that might work and might not work. I know it's most likely personal, but I'm sure that there are a couple of things that you can easily just point out. Okay, this, if you have this, know that is wrong. You have to work on it.
That would take like a whole training. I'm sure you know. But basically, it's to stay positive. Stay positive. Also internalize. Always, there's something called the mirror effect. But whatever you're about to do to someone, imagine that same thing being done to you. The way you feel is the way that person would feel. So before you do it, think about it. Something else that can be of value is for people to always think about what they're about to open their mouths to say. Listen, there's a reason why we have 2 eyes, 2 ears, or 1 mouth. So think about what you're about to say. Does it really matter? Does it matter for you to say it now? If it won't matter in a year from now, is it important for you to say it at all? I mean, so if you sit down yourself and look at your last 2 days and think about it, how many things did I say that really would count 5 days from now, would count 2 months from now, would count a year from now? Then you begin to censor what comes out of your mouth. And then that may help you guard your own attitude. Even if you have a negative attitude, if you can keep it internally till you work on it, and then turn into positive, you're on the way.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Shola.